Hi there. Today we're going to talk about replacing your old thermostat with the new nSpiration series thermostat. To do that, you're going to need to install it. The first thing when installing a unit is to turn the circuit breaker off.
Now that we've turned the circuit breaker off, we're going to loosen up this screw on the faceplate of this unit and go ahead and remove the faceplate, because that's going to let us get at the screws that are holding the base in the wall. The next step is to take this base out and mark the location of the wires, because we're going to transfer the wires from this unit to the brand new unit that you just received. Okay, we're going to disconnect these connections and then get them ready for the new one. We're looking at the back of the thermostat right now, and you can see there's four wires coming out of this thermostat. If you look on the wires coming out of the thermostat, you can see the word floor on these stickers. If those stickers are not present on your particular thermostat, look down at the base and you'll see the two wires in the middle represented by this line drawing stand for load. That is going to the floor. So floor means load. And if you look here, you can see L2 and L1. This is your line. So we're going to go ahead and mark the wires attached to here as the line. I've got tape marked line and load, so I know which wires get transferred to the correct spot on the back of the thermostat. So I'm going to take, first of all, the line. Mark those like that. I'm just going to put these around the load wires coming from the floor. I'm loosening these screws, but I'm not taking them out. They will naturally just stop turning. And when they do stop turning, don't force them, because that's going to allow you to get the wire down underneath that metal bracket that's directly under the screw. Okay, we've taken the unit here and you can see the bottom. We're going to flip it upside down and take off this plastic piece. And that's going to show us where the load gets attached and where the line gets attached. So what I'm going to do is, this is right side up, and I want the line wires to come in here, just as so. I'm going to get the wires snug underneath the metal bracket. So now our line matches line. Next item is to get the floor wired to this. So here we can see that this is the top. We're going to want to run these wires through here like this, so the wires are coming out the same direction. Notice the barrier there that's going to keep these wires from touching that exposed wire there. So we're going to take these, we're going to straighten them out from our previous connection, and we're going to put the floor under the load. Mark this with load, matches the word load, and we're going to stick this in here. The mat has no polarity. It does not matter which one goes to which, but for continuity's sake, we'll just go ahead and put it in this way too. Black does not have to match anything. Red does not have to match anything. There is no polarity in the mat. Then we go ahead and tighten it down, making sure that we don't put the metal bracket down on the plastic insulation. You want to see just a small hair of wire visible as you are tightening this down, because if you tighten this down on the plastic wire insulation, you may not get a connection at all, or you may get an intermittent connection, and that's not what you want. So we're going to get that placed just like that. The ground is going to go to a ground screw inside the box, which has probably already been connected once. And now, once we have our connections done, we're ready to put the plastic cap over the back until it snaps in. The next thing we have to do is the last thing before we mount the thermostat is to get the sensor wire placed onto this unit. We've removed it from the old unit. Now we're ready to put it on the new unit. Please take note, there are four connection spots here, A, B, C, and D. If you look at C and D, it says sensor. And it doesn't matter which wire goes in there. There is no polarity to the sensor. You just need to make sure that you get it in C and D, and then feed the cable in through the base of the unit. Make sure your wires are nice and tight. Screw the terminal down. Pull on the wires, make sure they're tight, and they are. And then feed the cable out through the hole. Make sure you get a nice tight fit. Now it's ready to go back into the wall. Okay, now we can go ahead and get our base put into the wall, and we'll be all ready to go to get it mounted. We've got the base of the thermostat squared up, and it's plumb up and down, so we're going to go ahead and put our screws in, make any final adjustments before we tighten them all the way down, and if we're happy with the level and plumb of the base, we'll go ahead and tighten it down, and that will allow us to go ahead and put the faceplate on. All right, we've got our base installed, and no matter what model of thermostat you have that you've gotten from us, if it's in the Inspiration line, the same base is applicable to each one of the units. So just because you see that we're using a touch unit here, this can also be used for doing the other units too. So we've got this in. We want to make sure that we be careful of this. This is the GFI test button. When you're putting the faceplate on, you want to make sure that you don't knock this off. So you're just going to put this in here like this, get it centered over that switch, that push button, and then we're going to push it in, and we'll tighten the screw down. And at that point, we're ready to go turn the circuit breaker on. Okay, now that we have the thermostat hooked up, all we need to do is turn the circuit breaker on, powering that thermostat, and we'll be ready to go.